Good morning, everyone. My name is Yao Yu, and today I'm very happy to be here to give you guys a presentation about my summer research. My faculty mentor is Professor Zhenya Zhang in Solid State Electronics Lab. And my project title is VLSI Architecture and Implementation of High Performance Error Correction Non-Binary LDPC Decoders. And let's first turn to an outline of my today's presentation, and these are some of the outlines. And first, let's go to the introduction and background. What is an LDPC code? LDPC codes are kind of low-density parity-check codes, and its performance is very close to the Shannon limit when decoded iteratively than other kinds of codes. And also, its transmission power is very low. There are several ways to categorize the LDPC codes. The first kind of method is the regular or irregular. A regular LDPC code is a kind of code that has the same row weight and the column weight. There's another kind of classification that we can divide the LDPC codes into binary LDPC codes and non-binary LDPC codes. There are also several kinds of representation of the LDPC code. You can see the top one is a binary LDPC parity check matrix, and the bottom one is a non-binary LDPC parity check matrix. And then for the last representation method is the factor graph, and you can see clearly what the connections are. And there are also several kinds of decoding algorithms for LDPC code. The belief-propagation algorithm, the sum of product algorithm, and the mean sum approximation. You can see the cheap micro photograph of the binary LDPC decoders using sum of product algorithm. And these graph in the bottom, this shows the general decoding process of the LDPC decoders. You can see clearly that there are two flows of messages, the variable to check messages and the check to variable messages. Also, what is the future choice? What is the more efficient way to design the decoders? I think that it's the non-binary codes, because the performance is quite good closing to the Shannon limit than binary codes, and the transmission power is quite low, and the interconnect for non-binary codes is much easier than the binary codes. Well, there's also some disadvantages brought by the non-binary codes, because the complexity becomes higher and the speed becomes lower. But these two problems can be easily fixed by design. These are some of the simulations we did in this summer. First, I tried the H120 and 71 non-binary LDPC codes over GF16. It's just a lower Gallus field code. And the rate is 0.5917. And you can see the plot. These are the plot, and it's very close to the Shannon limit here. And these are the data. Also, we do some fixed point simulation, and these are the three simulations we did. The first one is 6-bit for integer. The second one is the 7-bit for integer, and the third one is 8-bit for integer. And the following are their corresponding plots, and you can see they are also very close to the Shannon limit with a very good performance. And these are the error profiles we get from the H120 and 71. From this plot, we can easily see that the errors in a non-binary LDPC decoder are all high-weight errors. That means the errors has a lot of bit error in a single symbol area. That's an important point that we get. Also, we try a higher-order Gallus field non-binary LDPC code that which is the 104.267 over GF64, and the rate is 0.5297, which is close to the GF16 case. and these are the plot, and you can see that the plot goes straight down from 4 to 5, and this is the critical region of this LDPC code. And what we are going to continue for in the future or in the next semester is that we do some architectural level design and analyze. First of all, we need to complete the system as a pipeline, and we also wanted to use some technologies such as normalization, offset correction, and clipping to make our system become more efficient. And some other things we can do is that on-chip interconnect design to group some wires together to get our very neat on-chip. Also, we can do some revision on the algorithm to get a more powerful effect. Finally, I will do some conclusions about what I get from the summer research. The first is that the performance of the non-binary LDPC codes is much better than the binary codes, and these are the most important points. And the second is that proper quantization will influence the performance, which can be fixed by certain kind of technologies such as normalization and offset correction. Also, errors occurring in non-binary cases are all high weight errors, which may be fixed by some revision of the algorithm. These are the second very important point we get. And then the interconnect of the non-binary case can be grouped together to reduce the wiring complexity. And theoretically, the performance will be better with a higher Galois field, but we find that the mean sum approximation will make it worse in reality. So we need to find a way to fix this point. And finally, we will focus in the future in will be regular LDPC codes because it's much easier to build in a circuit than irregular LDPC codes. Thank you very much. These are all my presentation about my summer research about LDPC codes. I'm very happy to be here. These are some of the references. Thank you very much.